items or the person required to be picked up from the wilderness was so much that, yes, we had to take risks in bad weather, go pick that person up and come back to the ship, or drop him in Maitri or our station Gangotri and come back to the ship. If you don't come back to the ship, then next morning when you see the helicopter, then again it requires extra servicing and good visibility to fly back. Yeah.
Thank you.
Yes, sir. Most Hello, welcome. Sir. Sir.
Hello.
Hello, sir.
Naidigar, please.
Yes.
Sir, I'm ex-sergeant AP Naidu.
Naidu, please.
Sir, last time when you talked, I remembered about my Kumbhikram.
Yes, okay.
Now, when you talk now, I recollected my memories at the Ladakh and Thoys. I am so yes. fortunate to work there in Thoys for about 8 months.
Okay.
So it's very, very nice, very nice. I am recollecting my memories back. And now, two questions. What is the temperature range you have experienced? Maximum, minus, and minimum minus.
Minus was anything it could go. In my sixth expedition, I noticed minus 25.
But minus 20.
We never ventured there. Ours was on the Antarctica base. It was zero.
It's a comfortable range.
It's comfortable range. But we used to joke amongst ourselves, it is plus zero or minus zero.
Yeah. Whether we can play with X or with oranges.
Yes.
Whether we
yes.
can play our cricket with X or oranges.
Yes.
So, next question, sir. How the waste is disposed of there?
Okay. Please remember, 40 degree, between 40 degree and 60 degree, that water is warm enough. Below 60 yes. degree, beyond 60 degree,
yes.
it is cold.
Yes.
Nothing disintegrates there. Yes. Biodegradation does not take place. So, all the ships, what they do is, they collect the waste items, the toilet items, all collected in one tank. The waste, the throwaway vegetable waste, throwaway papers, throwaway anything, these are all kept separate. Papers are brought back to mainland India. Whereas the toilet waste, once we come to 40 degrees of warm water, it is released in phases. It is not in one place so much. It is released in small, small phases, small, small amounts outside into the sea, but never in the cold water. Okay, there was very clear instruction given to us. All the items, food items, were in the plastic bags. There was one boy who just threw the plastic bag. So the ship captain came and said, "Do not throw the plastic bag. Open it and throw the waste. Keep the plastic bag. You cannot put the plastic into the water." Okay, so that is how the waste were disposed in the warm waters. But solid waste, which can be brought back to the mainland, which was brought back. Anything more?
Yeah.
I was there in 1974, sir. There in Thoys, the waste disposal was a big problem, because anything you throw,
yes.
it gets iced up.
Yes.
Even when you keep taking bath, the water, it will come forming ice to our feet.
Exactly.
So it becomes very, very difficult to deal with the wastage yes. in yes. those periods. But it was a life of fear and fun. Nobody will experience such things yes. in civil.
Exactly.
So I was very fortunate. I pray, I always thank God for having given me this opportunity, and you have seen more in depth, and you have been more useful to the country and to the Air Force. I am really very proud. I am very proud of you, sir. Thank you.
No, yes, sir.
Now, another thing also, today I have got one point to follow. That is, when you said you give an atlas, I used to distribute Vivekananda books in the nearby schools as a president of Rotary Club or in my individual capacity. Now I will make a point to present an atlas in all the children's birthdays and also in the schools. Thank yes. you for giving me this wonderful yes. idea, sir.
Yes, sir. Okay, sir. Now we have...
One minute. In the last meeting, just... TBR, 1 minute. In yes. the last meeting, I said sir. That sir. I spent 1.5 months in the winter on ground in Bhutan.
Bhutan.
Okay. Yes. What you said just now reminded me that...
Yes, sir.
Yes. Water is extremely cold. We are used yes. to heating up water and having a yes. bath by the mugs, no doubt.
Yes.
I experienced a local Bhutanese. He had a bathtub made of stones, which is in the open. Okay. In the open. All we did, yes. all he did was, nearby there was fire. He heated the stones and put the stones into the water.
Yes.
Oh. And the water used to go slowly warm, and he used to have a dip in that.
Okay.
So yes. this was the first time I saw water stones being heated and put in the water, and the water heated up in the small little tub which he created artificially, not the tub you are used to, and he had a bath there. So that is what you reminded me just now.
Do you have Bukharis there, sir? Bukharis?
Those are all the modern times we introduced to them. They had different kinds of eating. They had different kinds of eating. If you remember, in Srinagar cold areas, inside their
clothes,
they have the small little bukhari to warm up their warm body.
Now, sir,
Brigadier Apte sir is also on the call. Sir, welcome,
yes.
sir.
Yes, hello,
welcome
sir. Apte,
also
sir.
Speak, sir. Brigadier Apte sir.
So, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Absolutely.
Wing Commander Krishnamurthy sir, excellent. As always, you have given a fantastic account of the Antarctic expedition. Having known you right from the NDA days and 71 war, my salute to you. Excellent. Very versatile.
My salute return, sir. Thank you.
Versatile person. I just have one point to clarify. Since Thoise was mentioned, that is Mr. TBR, where the Indian Army's, you know, first base was for the Siachen Glacier, which we have been occupying since 1994.
Yes.
And I must accept here that the lifeline for Siachen has been the excellent support of our Indian Air Force, especially the helicopter pilots. And all my three regiments, the one which I commanded and fought the 71 war with, has served at 19 to 23,000 feet in Siachen. So also my other two regiments, where I was second in command and a battery commander, all have served in the Siachen Glacier. And as Wing Commander Krishnamurthy has mentioned, it's a very, very difficult task, but we are performing that right since 1984. That is one point. The other point, sir, I have is that this station which we have established, Bharati Station, I think in 2012 in the Antarctica.
Yes, yes.
That I presume is an upgrade from the 1989 one. And I just wanted to know the heliport which has been established there. Is it manned round the year, or only are there some times when it gets occupied and controlled? That is one. Secondly, India is part of the Antarctic Treaty which was signed, which, if I am not wrong, dictates that there will be no military presence at the Antarctic. Is that correct? That's all.
No. There will be, I repeat, no. The Antarctic Treaty system says to demilitarize Antarctica, to establish it as a zone free of nuclear tests and the disposal of radioactive material, to ensure that it is used for peaceful purposes only, to promote international scientific cooperation in Antarctica, to set aside disputes over territorial sovereignty. There is no, other than this, for scientific purpose, you are allowed there. Your troops are also allowed, so long as it is not for occupational, so long as it is only for logistic support of the team.
Right, sir. That's great. But who controls the space management and the visits there? Is US doing it, or someone else has been deputed for that?
See, the US and USSR, they have right on the pole, South Pole itself, they have their station. Okay. We have started in a mild way, in a small way, the Maitri, and now with Bharati. Bharati, I have details, but I'm not having it now. He is about 3,000 kilometers away from Maitri in the east. That is, it is directly south of India. It is, I think, 71 degree east or something, 071 east or something like that. It is directly south of India, and you all have to do is travel along the Indian Ocean and just go there. But most of this commuting is done by the ship. Most of the commuting is done by the aeroplane. As I told you earlier, 2-3 countries have joined together and say, I am in touch with the NIO, Goa, National Institute of Oceanography. They have kind things to say about these people. So I meet them sometimes when I go to Goa and also get information. See the small little snippets I picked up. Okay. Does that answer your question, Ajit?
Yes, sir. Thank you very much. Very kind of you, sir. Thank you.
Acha, TBR, there is one Manjunath. He has put the hands up. Just ask him, please.
Yes, sir. Yeah, Manjunath. Yeah, you are audible. Yes, you can speak.
Little louder.
One is what lesson?
You can keep the
sir, your mic voice is low. Your voice is
you can keep
low.
The mic closer to your mouth.
I have two questions. Am I audible now fully?
Not fully.
Now? Hello.
Yeah, you try your question.
And the benefits as a country we have derived from these expeditions so far. That is my first question. And second question, why was the Indian naval ships not used for these expeditions?
No. The first question is, what is the benefit for the nation for conducting this expedition?
Oh, beautiful. When we talked about the Antarctica treaty system, if you don't sign a treaty system, if you're not part of the Antarctica, you cannot do experiments there. Okay. Antarctica being a kind of no man's land once upon a time, and it is not habitable even now, is a place like a laboratory where you can conduct experiments of various kinds. India has joined hands with East Germany, now Germany, USSR, and the world to conduct experiments. And besides Antarctica, India has started Arctic programs also, which we will discuss some other day. Though we are not part of the team, but we will discuss about the Arctic team, which the Antarctica National Institute of Oceanography has undertaken to be there in the Arctic. So it is for the general experiments which we require, like ozone hole. You must have heard of the ozone hole, attrition of the ozone hole closing and opening. So it is all part of the experiments done there in Antarctica. That is the reason we are part of this thing. You may wonder, this is the answer for the people who say, why are we wasting so much of money going and coming Antarctica? It is like any other expedition. You have defense such a lot. You don't fight every day. Why you have a defense process? Why have them trained? Why have them this thing like that? So idea is to be ready for any kinds of thing in the world. And our country is not small. Our country is very big. And we have to be ready with the answers the world is asking. In the recent time, we have given vaccines to many countries. Leave aside the rest of the politics. We were ready with the vaccines, even before the thing. So we should be ready with Antarctica experiments also, even before other questions say, what have we done in so many years of independence you had? So this is the reason we are part of the Antarctica experiments. Does that answer your question, Munjuna?
I think it answers your first question, sir. And now we have Wing Commander Karnik, sir, also, sir, Veer Chakra holder on the call. Sir, we'd like
one
to
minute,
ask...
Before that, CP Singh. Veteran CP Singh.
Go
ahead with your question.
Sir, many, many congratulations to you, Wing Commander Sodhi, sir, Wing Commander Venkatesh, and Mr. Datta, sir.
Accepted.
Achha, sir, my very simple question. Sir, you started your journey from Goa by a big ship. Sir, were you trained on swimming? All members were trained on swimming.
Yes, a very good question. These days, I am training the young seafarers and the offshore workers on the sea survival and HUET, helicopter underwater escape training. That is, in case the helicopter fails and does ditching on the water, how are you going to get out of the helicopter to survive? We were given basic information about the ship initially. But on board the ship, every third week, we had an emergency training explanation on how to get onto the boat. The biggest thing, if you have a problem on the ship, is to reach your boat number. You can't just go to the boat which is nearby, lifeboat. You have to go to the boat which has been assigned to you. So each one had a particular number, lifeboat number, and we were told by the ship's crew how to reach, how to disengage the boat from the ship and get onto the water. Does that answer your question? We were not given any special training. Our sea survival, desert survival, and jungle survival, what we learned on board the helicopter, that was sufficient. We started flying offshore, we were given sea survival training too. Yeah.
Sir, my second question almost same. Were you carrying out the exercise lowering the boats again bringing the boats to the ship during your stay?
That was done. Once we reached Antarctica, they took the boats out, they lowered it into the water, brought it back. I saw them personally. Okay. But during the other training, we were only told how to untie, how to deploy the boat into the water. That is your numbered boat. Please remember that. Each one has each section of people had one particular number boat. Only there you have to go.
Thank you very much, sir. We have learned many things today. Many, many thanks to you and your team, sir. Especially Mr. Rao and Sarath Pathak, sir. Thank you very much.
Like Naidu said, please buy one atlas today.
Definitely, sir. We will buy.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
So, Vinkamakarnik, sir.
Yeah.
Sir.
Thank you, one and all speakers who have given this information. We are very, very happy to hear all this explanation. Thank you.
Okay. Most welcome, sir.
Yeah.
I always tell people, not only the atlas, a small little geometry box also to be given to the youngsters. Idea is to do everything neatly. Even if you want to draw a circle, don't draw a rough circle. Draw with a compass. Okay.
Thank you, sir. And General Pathak, sir.
May I come in, sir?
Please.
One second. Now, General Pathak, sir, is coming.
Sir, you are telling that by helicopter, you are carrying some building material, construction work. So, what type of construction was done there on ice?
Okay. Construction materials were mostly prefabricated. It was not cement and it was not chuna and sand. No. We were carrying prefabricated on angles. All you have to do is put them together and put one nut and bolt.
Framework and panels.
Yes. And we also carried what you call them as the compartment, cabins, prefabricated cabins too. Yes. That also we carried. Yes. We carried them. And those things we left it to the snow cat for, the ship offloaded them onto the ground, on the berth, and the snow cat picked them up and went away. As far as the helicopter was concerned, dismantled, prefabricated construction items we had.
And another question is, what was the power source for the turbine stations there?
Generators.
Okay, generators.
We had high power generator, standby. Then we had 10 redundant items because that was most important. Without electricity, you cannot survive. Okay. And please remember, in the cold area like Antarctica, if you catch fire, there is no water available easily.
Mm.
It is death for sure.
Okay.
These are the things I understood very clearly. This was made to understand in the onboard the ship when we talked of the cold areas in the world. That is the North Pole area, Arctic, North Europe. The ship's crew told us, then I read it in the novels and books about this. So the biggest enemy there is the weather, and biggest enemy number two is the fire. You have to be very careful. Be very, very careful. There is no water available, please. You can't put snow onto the fire and say, get lost. No.
Okay. Sir, one question that Mr. Manjunath asked, only one we could answer. Second one he has written here. So my question was, what lessons and benefits we as a country have derived from these expeditions? A second one is, why was the Indian naval ship deployed for this expedition?
Okay.
Why was the Indian naval ship deployed?
Yes, sir. Yes. It is surprising to note that the guys, scientists, explorers who went to North Pole, they all were from North Europe area, Arctic area, like the Norwegian lands, English people or Russians. Why I'm saying this is that experiment, that living there had given them what is cold, how to handle cold. Okay, we in India, even today, the Navy is warm water area, warm water force, not a cold water force. Okay, I'm not able to use the right term, so don't mind my words, anyone listening to me, as far as the ship is concerned. So we have not used the thing. And that time, of course, we had no big ship of this kind. We had to pay a lot of money on board to get on board that to charter the MV Thulaland from Sweden, a Swedish ship it was. Okay. And how these people take you through the ice is an experiment by itself. So among the captains of the ship, they have somebody called cold water area, cold water, ice. Can you do ice navigation? That is, ice navigation is taking the ship through the cold. see through the eyes, broken eyes. If you see the photographs I sent you, there are flow, F-L-O-E, flow, snow flows, all broken eyes. Okay, we don't go around dashing against the ship because ship will break. The iceberg or the ice are very, very strong. It is solid water. Okay, so it is the speciality. So we looked for the speciality from the Sweden. Again, cold area, Arctic area. They are within the Arctic Circle. Please remember that. Norway, Sweden and Denmark, Norwegian country. They are within the Norwegian Arctic Circle. They have extreme experience on this. That is why we chose them. Okay, second question.
I think, why was Indian naval ship was deployed for this?
No, we had no ship of that caliber. That's okay. All.
Right, sir. Thank you, nothing sir. Else. And we have Mr. J.D. Singh. You can unmute and ask, sir.
Yeah, Commander Nikhil, go ahead. Where are you, Nikhil?
Yeah, Mr. Commander Nikhil.
Sir, may I come in?
Yeah, please come.
Yeah, please. Come. Please, aye.
Sir, myself, B.S. Sharma.
Boliye.
I started Air Force from 77 to 98 as a flight engineer. My question is to Wing Commander Swati, sir. Sir, during your course of flying, anytime you have faced any major emergency, normally every aircrew faces emergencies which you could avoid and safely. Please narrate it.
Wing Commander Swati, sir.
Unmute. Sorry.
As you said, emergency during flying. I did about 7,000 hours of flying. Emergencies do happen, but God grace, I survived all of them and I'm sitting here to speak to you.
Great, but
in Antarctica, we didn't face any emergency as such. Only weather was the emergency. We had to fight with weather. Helicopters were well maintained and always available, fully serviceable to fly. And we found no problem at all with the accessibility of helicopters. Otherwise, in flying hours all over Mizoram, Nagaland, all over, emergency used to take place, but never had such an emergency where I had to put down the helicopter crashing site. Only I could manage to put down helicopter safely ground wherever you found. I used to not maintain always on a helipad only. We have landed on ground other than that also, but put the helicopter on ground safely.
Yeah, CP, J.D. Singh, sir.
Who is next coming?
J.D. Singh, I think he has raised his hand. Yeah, Mr. J.D. Singh. You have to unmute and speak.
You have to unmute.
Unmute and speak.
Don't switch off the video.
Okay, sir. Yeah. Okay, now, sir. Yeah. Sir, you're getting me?
Yeah, yeah. Yes, yes. You can speak.
Sir, good afternoon to you all, sir. My question, sir, is whatever the lab we are establishing there, is it leftover like that only and it remains for years together or it destroys?
Please understand. It is manned, sir. 24 hours. We have team wintering there. You understand what is wintering?
Right.
They don't go in only in Antarctica summer and come back. They stay throughout the year. When they come, it is handed over to the next person.
Right, okay. Sir. Right, sir.
Yeah, yeah. It is not left in the wilderness at all. Yes, there was a time, I remember, we had left our chalks in some place.
Uh-huh.
But next year, we went and picked it up because there is no one to steal it.
That's right. No, but okay. what is my question?
And it doesn't catch rust there in Antarctica. It is dry.
Right. My question was that because of the storm or because of the weather condition, does it destroy?
No. The containers made for Antarctica is special.
Right.
It is all weather.
Right. Okay. Sir.
And heavy. It is not just liftable. If you see the photographs, if you go to the net and see Antarctica right. program, you will see lots of photographs.
Exactly.
It cannot just fly. And winds are very strong, no doubt. But it cannot carry a cabin.
Uh-huh.
Prefabricated cabin, it cannot carry. And right. there is always a gap between the ground and the construction. So the wind doesn't have the pushing effect. It just passes through underneath.
Oh, good.
So
that's right.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah. Now, sir. Okay. Wing Commander Kavatra, sir, if you'd like to speak to, I think, Wing Commander Kavatra, sir.
You said Wing Commander, Commander Nikhil. Where is he?
Yeah, Commander Nikhil also, we are waiting for him.
Okay.
And otherwise, Gopal Krishnan, sir. Mr. Gopal Krishnan. Yes, sir.
I have a question concerning the ecology in I'm sure there's a lot of waste generated, food waste, other general garbage, as well as the waste from the ship, that is oil. How do you dispose it off?
Yes, I had answered a question earlier about the disposal of garbage. All the solid garbage items are brought back to the mainland India back on board the ship. Wastage of toilet, wastage of vegetables, wastage of the kitchen are in phases dropped in the warm water that is beyond between 40 degrees and 60 degrees south. When we get away from Antarctica, we cross the Antarctica Circle. After that, the water is generally warm, and by 40 degrees, it is nice and warm. It is. That is where all these items, all this wastage are released. But in phases, in small quantities, not in large quantities.
Yes, sir. Okay, sir. Captain Reddy garu, Captain Reddy garu.
Anything? I didn't ask anything. Just
okay.
Okay.
Okay. Then anybody else, sir?
Any
Kothra sir is, I think, trying to speak. Yes, sir.
But Nicholas.
No, yeah, sir. I would like to thank Wing Commander Krish. The way he has explained the complete. His expedition, I suggest he should contact the TV serial people and make a couple of episodes. And it will be very educational for the generation to come, at least for we Indians. Well done, Krish. I hope you give it a thought, and you are sitting in Bombay, right place to venture out if it is possible. Well done. Very well narrated. Congratulations.
Thank you, Kwantra Sahab. Thank you, Kwantra Sahab. It's a good idea. The TBR and FATX, they are on the job towards this. I may tell you this.
Yes,
first
sir.
And foremost, they want to make my book, which contains a lot of writing, about 40 pages of writing on Antarctica alone, to make it sustainable to buy for the normal people and students. Yesterday, if I may quote Sharad Yadav, he said, if the book is brought below 150 rupees, there will be more people to buy. Or present book, if you give concession, discount, it will be bought. The unfortunate thing is, per book, I get 40 rupees. And that is, I have dedicated to ALC. And
Artificial Center. Yes, sir.
So if I give you some discount, I may give you within 40 rupees. But again, only 20 or 10 rupees will go to Artificial Limb Center. Which will be defeat. So in the bargain, what Sharad Yadav said, that go for a cheaper edition. Okay, let us see whether it is sustainable, idea is sustainable, whether it can be brought into the system. And I am also contributing one chapter for him for his book. That it will be of different nature, not on Antarctica, right?
Thank you, sir. So, any questions for sir from anybody? I think we have already washed out the time by 15 minutes.
It is, I meant to read Sharad Patak, not Yadav.
Sharad Patak, sir. Okay. So, I think we have come to the end of it, sir. Anything, sir? Wing Commander Sodhi, sir, would like to share before we leave the call?
Manoj?
It has been very, very pleasant meeting. And I think everybody who was available has learned a lot about Antarctica. Thanks a lot. Krishnamurti.
You're most welcome, sir. Idea is, I want to put the Antarctica WhatsApp group on to these people. They have several questions to ask various places. That day, we will keep quiet and they will ask questions. And Antarctica WhatsApp people will answer all the questions, all there is. Because getting a scientist like Manoj Datta talking, he may be in uniform, but he's a scientist. He's a weather scientist. So there are plenty more. Yes, Jaira sir.
Jaira,
please go ahead. Please unmute yourself and talk.
Please unmute, sir.
Anna.
Sir, good afternoon.
Yes,
good
sir.
Afternoon.
Yes, good afternoon, sir. Please.
Really, I had a good experience. Actually, I volunteered for the Antarctica trip, but I could not be selected because I have not trained at the time in Me8. MCF I have not done. And when will be the next meeting, sir?
Somewhere in June, we are hoping to meet the entire Antarctica WhatsApp group. That is scientists and Air Force pilots, engineers, and other service people. Okay.
Please include me also in the group, sir.
Yes, yes, we will send you the link. Please join us. Okay.
Yes,
yeah, yeah, like this today, it will be open to all. Our idea of conducting these kind of things is to give away the information, give away the knowledge, give away whatever we learned from the service to the service back. Okay.
Sir, I also want to tell my experience.
Yes.
Thais base camp, as well as from Baghdara to China border, where I retrieved one G-8 helicopter. Even though I am radio fitter, I led
that
team.
Okay, sir. Okay, definitely. Please, TBR note. Sharad Yadav, please note this. Jairaj got plenty to say, and then we will make use of his knowledge.
Sir, your phone number, sir?
2777.
Sir. Where are you, sir? Where are you from now?
Now I am settled in Delhi at present.
Okay, sir.
Beautiful.
Right, sir. We'll be in touch, sir. I'll talk to you personally.
Okay. I have done so many salvages.
Right, sir. Yeah, we'll definitely talk to you and discuss on that. So, now we have come to the, almost... sir, can we close if there are no questions?
If there are no questions, we may.
Yes, sir.
Any questions? Any last minute doubts?
Yeah.
Okay. I have a point. Just one point. Nikhil here.
Yeah. Nikhil, come on, Nikhil.
Yeah. My father would remember Captain N.K. Varma from the Navy was a Met officer on the 6th expedition. Maybe the next meeting you could include him. I can try and get his contact details for you. He was the Met officer in the 6th expedition. Yes.
Oh, yes. We had, I told you, we had Met officers from Air Force and the Navy, the aviation Met officers. This gentleman, Commander Varma, was with us on board the ship during the 6th expedition. We can call him, not a problem.
Yes, yeah, so I'll get the details and I'll pass on the details to you. You can get in touch with us.
And we will have many more. We will have, we even had thought of sending our Indian Air Force Met officers for wintering, but last minute it was cancelled. It was not acceptable to the Air Force. Okay, so the point here is we learned something through having been in the service and having undergone this experience. Idea is to put them all back to you. And from your side, please write down, start writing a journal. This journal is not a joke. I told you. Okay. So one must pick up a notebook, just start writing. Doesn't matter. It doesn't have to be very personal. I told him this, he told me that. No, you don't have to write like this. Write general things. It will be enough for you to remember many things. And it is of great value to the future generation. Please go ahead.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yeah. And finally, I think Subhash Chandra Garu from Hyderabad would like to ask anything, sir. You are waiting for so long.
Yes. Subhash, please unmute yourself if you have a question.
Now it is done.
Yeah.
See, actually, I was participating first time into this group. So I'm likely to understand what exactly the concepts and the flow of information and the knowledge which is really transitional from the seniors to the juniors or from known to unknown. So it is really a wonderful flow of information as an experience, particularly the real narration of the field experience and really who felt it and who experienced it. That is a first-hand information, which is really a wonderful knowledge input for me, like a people who are listening as a first time. And only one thing which I wanted to know, maybe slightly, it is not a technical issue, but when he said there were so many teams of Russians, Germans, Indians, etc., what was the psychological impact of team between the teams?
No, in our team, we didn't have these foreigners.
Not in your team, sir.
No. They were in their own camps. They were in their own camps. We met them only as socially or any requirement professionally or any requirement if you had to borrow some ration. That's all. Okay.
But they were not, there was no technical...
But I may tell you, the ship crew was Swedish.
Okay.
And their English and our English was the same because they were not the Englishmen talking in high slang. So we used to feel very comfortable talking to the Swedish people and many, many things we learned from them because they also required some kind of a pastime, some kind of a thing to go through. Okay. And liquor is not the only answer. Liquor was not the answer. It is the social interaction between the interpersonal relationship was a great thing. Okay. And that is what we experienced. Next time when Air Marshal Khajuria comes, he will repeat what I requested him. He was in the AEB. I used to tell him, I want the guys, flight engineers and flight gunners, who will be able to stay in the confined space of the ship for 4 months. This question I keep, this statement I keep making everywhere, because you do not know that how isolation makes you go wonky. Has anyone spent his time in Karnikovar?
Sir, as far as my small experience of isolation, I have done the solar energy plant at an altitude of around 17 to 18,000 feet height in Himalayan glaciers above the Gangotri, along with the ITBP. So this isolation and the psychological impacts, which have been very closely studied. So that is the reason which I have asked you this particular point with reference to the
You are talking about Antarctica and Gangotri, sorry, Himalayas.
Yeah, Himalayas around 17,000 feet height.
Yes,
there was a psychological impact on the soldiers. So exactly. What was the, I just wanted to know about that.
I'll give you an example. I spent 5 years in Kumbhigram. You know where is Kumbhigram? Silchar.
Yeah.
It's very regular air force. Yeah. There is only one, there is only one helicopter unit there.
Yes, sir.
And being accounts officer, station commander and education officer, somebody, admin officer.
Yeah.
Many times we have several aeroplanes landing there every day, but we feel isolated because it is so far away. There is a country in between your hometown and your place, foreign country, East Pakistan.
Bangladesh.
Okay. So isolation can come in the thinking process alone. It is not just isolation physical. So getting used to the isolation, getting not disturbed by the isolation is the important thing when we look for these kind of things. That is what I'm trying to say. Nothing else.
Okay. So, thank you, sir.
Thank you, Bhoskar, for your asking question. And I think we are now coming to the close. So before closing, then I would like to thank all the participants of today's program. Particularly our main speaker, Wing Commander Krish sir, then Wing Commander Sodhi sir, Wing Commander Venkatesh sir, and Manoj Gupta sir, and Commander Nikhil, and all the other, like now, our Wing Commander Karnik sir, the war hero, Wing Commander Group Captain Das sir, Wing Commander Kavatra sir, and finally
Brigadier Apte. Don't forget Brigadier Apte.
So great warrior Brigadier Apte sir, and we have Rajendra Group Captain Apte sir also was on the call, and sister of our Winko Krish, and my mentor JW Patakzi, and Naid Garu, then Dasi from Bengal, Jairaji, then we have Manjunaji, then JW Raghunaji, Gopal Krishnan sir, so Anand sir and Naid Garu, Anand Sapreji, Satyaji and Sudha, all so many others. I would like to again, thank you sir. Would like to ask sir, Anand sir. Okay. Thank you. So thank you all for making the program a grand success, and particularly thanks to our today's narrator, our Wing Commander Krishna sir and Sodhi sir, for beautiful narration, as if you have taken us to the Antarctic expedition without any spending any money. So wonderful, so inspiring, and so adventurous. Thank you so much, sir, for making this program a grand success.
Most welcome.
And before we close, I would like to announce the next Wednesday's webinar program. Wednesday webinar with our super success hero. Next time, we had the narration of our Sergeant to Vice Chancellor, Professor Sashi Narayana. Now, this coming Wednesday, we are having the program of a DIG, IPS officer, Airman to IPS officer. So he is now Ravi Kumar Murthy. So he is going to speak as the main speaker for the Wednesday webinar. I request all the warriors to be present for that also and make it a grand success. Thank you, sir. Thank you one and all for making this.